Hey guys, Fusebox here. This is basically a Fuse News update. These can be pretty fun. This is where we get to theorycraft and talk a little bit about some of the things we see coming that they're telling us are coming. If you want to watch the video yourself, just go to your news right here in What's Next in Raid Episode 3. Click Read More, hit Details, and you can watch this video. It's super cool. But basically, we've got a lot coming. Okay, a lot of new heroes. So there's going to be a lot of people are probably excited to hear about Dark Kale. We now know he is Kael, which makes a lot of more sense, actually. But I'm going to keep calling him Kale. That way, every time you're trying to eat your Kale chips, you think of your little Dark Elf buddy. So it looks like he's going to be a lot stronger with poisons. Surely they'll be the stronger version. There are other people, content creators in the program. I do not have enough viewers yet, so I can't get in the content creator program, but they have information out there. Go check them out. By the way, subs, please give them to me. Maybe one day I can get in there. I appreciate your time. I appreciate all the support that you give me. But back to the game. Two new Doom Tower bosses. This is super exciting. A little bit of something to mix it up. They look tough. One of them is this giant flame demon, and he puts out these ginormous bombs, and they pretty much tell you there's nothing you can do about it except for they mentioned they can be frozen. And they also mentioned putting your own explosions out trying to kill the boss. Sounds an awful lot like Ninja has a perfect place to be with a full AoE freeze. He can freeze those bomb things and also put the HP burn on the boss. So they've already given us some of the tools we're probably going to be using to get through one of those bosses. But, you know, you very well may be breaking out, you know, some of your freeze characters that you normally don't use. I mean, even if she's booked out, nobody uses Pixneal, poor Pixneal, but she has a 5-hitter at random. But when booked out, each hit has a 50% chance to freeze. If anything takes 2 hits, it freezes. There are plenty of other people who could freeze. You might have is it Lua can do a freeze. So a lot of new heroes might be coming out, might be mixing them up with Drakstar and somebody like Lua, but Ninja sure does seem like he fits the bill for what they described in that video. I'm gonna let you watch the video. I'm not gonna narrate the whole thing. And then the other boss, the Fae, definitely looks interesting. She can banish a character, making them unusable. Now they don't take damage during this time, but they cannot act. But when she does this, she makes a mirror image or a copy of that character, and you've got to kill them to unbanish your hero. Don't really know about her, the damage she does, or any of the other abilities she's going to have, but what a neat idea. Like, this is definitely outside of the box. I love things like that. So we'll have to figure out, you know, like, in my mind, do we bring glass cannons and good support champions so that whoever gets banished, we can kill them quickly and get back to the boss? It's going to be interesting. Might be able to block abilities. We'll just have to see what we're going to do. So definitely fun. Definitely cool news. There's now the clan. The addition to some clan activity. Speaking of which, if we're going to go there, join the Black Hand Guild. We're definitely still looking to fill our ranks. It's X911, open invite, just jump on in. We're fun, we're active, we're not a super strong guild. So if you feel like that's what you're looking for, come on over. You can be brand new. We don't care. Just if you enjoy the game, want to have fun with us, come on over. We try to help each other out. There's going to be all these new, there's some interesting quests, clan quests, where it sounds like you choose. I don't know if maybe the leaders of the clan will choose who does, you know, what mission during this event. A lot of mystery around it right now. But that does mean we'll be communicating more. And even in a close-knit clan like ours, you know, there's just times it goes quiet. And this game needs a reason to talk, something to talk about. So that's super cool. There's going to be rewards for it. There's going to be like a clan currency, clan gold that you can spend on Lord knows what yet, but hopefully it's worth it. It might be like the bazaar, maybe one or two items you want, and then the rest is just eh. But we'll find out. At least they're doing it, and if it's not that great, it'll be easy to not participate. kind of like clan versus clan. It's, you know, in the end, I think most clans just are trying to get their milestone rewards. They're really decent rewards just for kind of doing something. They don't really care about battling it out with the clan. So, you know, it's more about just getting those rewards. So hopefully that will improve the game. There's some really cool champs coming out. Definitely want to go check out some of the bigger content creators who have access to what these heroes do, but be watching your news ticker. They're going to be sneaking things out as more about the Doom Tower bosses as it approaches, because I think we're only about a week away. So definitely a lot to look forward to. And currently, right now, if you're watching this right now, they have this event where if you pull 40 shards, you get Geomancer. This guy, all because of this passive, he does like Brogni. When he reflects damage, he can proc Giant Slayer. You get him in a Giant Slayer. Every time you take a slam, the entire team reflects damage. Each one of those, that's five hits, has a chance of actually proccing his Giant Slayer. So the numbers can really get high. Really good to throw in on a clan boss team. Especially under Affinity, where you're taking two slaps on those AoEs. That could be up to 10 hits. 10 procs of Giant Slayer. So obviously a cool champ if you've been sitting on a bunch of shards. You know, I'm sitting at 12. I'm gonna hold on to everything I got for the next, you know, there's one coming, another fusion or fragment event, probably just weeks away. So I gotta save up, try to get ready for that. But the game, there's a lot coming, a lot of quality of life improvements. They're gonna give us more space. I wish they made it cheaper. When you go into like extend your vault, it costs so much. I just do it every now and then when I feel like it's time. But to increase like more space, it gets expensive. You know, you're giving up precious gems or lots of silver. I'm not at a point where I'm like overwhelmed with space. I pretty much, when faction war or yeah, clan versus clan comes around, I start feeding all my epics into epics and rares into rares and just using those as books to get a ton of points. But, you know, eventually there are so many characters in this game, you're going to want a lot of space, and it does get expensive, especially like I have gone a pretty good ways on my here on my list. And I mean, it just gets higher and higher, but they're going to give us, I think, 100 more slots. I don't know if they're going to give it to us or make us purchase it. I assume purchase it because that's how they roll. There is going to be, in clan versus clan, you earn these like perks. It kind of looked a little like the Great Hall, where you get these things where you earn more silver as a clan by being active when you're grinding out 12-3 or whatever. Definitely clans are going to want to work hard to get those things up so that everybody's actually earning more silver. You see how silver is, right? If I want to get up and go to the bathroom, Plarium wants like 1.5 million silver. That's where we're at. So a new way to get silver is super needed. And then they talked about the dupe system. I'm not going to get hyped and I'm not going to get upset about it. Right now, all they really said is there's going to be options. And I think that's good. Anytime there's options, that's going to be a wonderful way to actually, you know, tackle a problem. So they may have something where you can power up a hero, or, well, we don't know. They didn't really give us any clue, but I do know that there's going to be different options for long-term and short-term uses of dupes. So keep holding on to those good dupes, those legendary dupes, if you've got them. And hopefully there's ways to use both of them, and maybe they get us an extra bit of ability when you use two of the same character. I think that would be cooler than just feeding one into another one for a permanent boost. Some people would maybe prefer that, you know. But let me know what you think about the bosses. What do you think about the dupe system? It, you know, all you can do is guess, speculation, right? But it might be. It sounds like they thought it out a little deeper than the last time they made an announcement. So I'll take that. The new clan stuff, as long as they don't fill us on their end, that's going to be fun. A reason to get on your separate chats on Discord and the line app, whatever you do, and actually communicate like, okay, hey, I can handle this mission if you want to do this one. Sounds like a little bit of fun. We'll see how it goes. So that's it, guys. I just wanted to go over what's happening, and I need to get in here and play my game, earn some points for my clan so we can get our milestones and be done with this. Until next time, enjoy the grind.